Moonhack 2023, code along with Kaye. Space Shoes Project. Project exemplar being demonstrated.
Greetings, Moonhackers. Welcome to our code along. Today's project is the Space Shoes Project. Did you know the technology that we have in our joggers today was actually created for astronauts? The rubber absorption material that they had was actually designed for their space helmets so that while they were travelling, they had the best protection possible. Today, we use that in our sports shoes, particularly for athletes looking to get that little bit of an edge. So let's jump into the project. Hopefully you've got this open on your screen, but if not, use the hyperlink in the project materials to take you there.
Title screen, sprites and costumes.
To get started, let's get ourselves set up so that we're all good to go. The first thing I'm going to do is rename my project so that I know what it is for me. So I'm going to put Kaye's space shoe.
Kaye is typing.
In today's project, we're going to create a game where the user can click on all parts of the shoe and change it to be able to create their own space shoe. The way that we do this is that we're using costumes, and for each of the sprites, if we click on the costumes tab, we will see a number of costumes available for the shoe. To start with, we have 5 sprites, and we're starting with the shoe top sprite. We're going to start with the event when the green flag is clicked, and we're going to choose the costume that it needs to start with. So in here, I want it to start with the costume that's called shoe top, as we're working on the shoe top. I want my user to be able to click on the shoe and change the costume. So let's create that algorithm. When this sprite is clicked, we're going to change to the next costume. Now, one thing I need to do extra on this sprite is to make sure it stays at the back, because I have my logo sprite and my laces sprite that need to be on top. So I'm also going to add in one block that tells this sprite to go to the back layer. So let's test out our code. I'm on my shoe sprite, and when I click it, it's going to rotate through all of the different costumes that I have, so I can choose the one I like the most. And when I'm ready to start again, I click the green flag and it goes back to its original shoe costume. We need to go and create these 2 algorithms for each of the other sprites. So let's do that. Click on the shoe bottom sprite. If you remember our algorithm, when the green flag is clicked, I'm going to tell it to start with the costume that's called shoe bottom. Then I'm going to start my other algorithm. When this sprite is clicked, I want it to go to the next costume. I don't need to add the other block that tells it what layer to go to because there's nothing on this one. I'm going to test it just to make sure it's working. Oh, now I can really start creating the kind of shoe that I would like to have. Let's click on the logo sprite. And the same 2 algorithms are going to be created. With the event, when the green flag is clicked, I want it to start on the costume that is the astronaut. It's my choice of starting. The second algorithm, when this sprite is clicked, going to go to the next costume. I know that my codes are working, so I'm not going to test this one yet. I'm going to finish with the last 2 sprites. So when the green flag is clicked, switch to the costume, and I want it to start with white. My shoes are white here with the laces to begin with. And when this sprite is clicked, I want it to go to the next costume. Okay, we've got our 4 ready to go. I'm going to get to starting positions. Now, if I click my logo, it's going to change. And if I click the laces, they change color too. So now I can create a really unique shoe that I'm really happy with.
Title screen, game instructions.
Now our project, we can extend it out a little bit further. At the moment, the person coming to play our game won't know what to do. So we're going to get the astronaut to give some instructions. Let's click on the astronaut sprite down the bottom. Now we need the instructions at the very beginning. So let's start with the event when the green flag is clicked. And our astronaut is going to give instructions through some thought bubbles. So let's grab the think bubble. And our first one's going to start with, I love my space shoes.
Kaye is typing.
Let's add another think bubble and put in, can you,
Kaye typing,
design a new style for me with a question mark? You'll change that to 3 seconds. I think that will take a little bit longer to read. Another think bubble now to tell them exactly what to do.
Kaye typing.
Click on each part of the shoe. I might leave that one for 3 seconds as well, just to really make sure they're going to be able to understand the instructions. Now, I want to create a bit of movement for our lovely astronaut, so I'm going to start another algorithm also with the green flag event, because I want him to start moving at exactly the same time. I'm going to use a forever control block, and inside that, I'm going to tell my astronaut to glide, to look like he's moving in space. But I don't want to tell him exactly where to go. I might swap that block out for glide to random position. Now, if the astronaut's in space, things move fairly slowly there. So let's do perhaps 8 seconds as a really nice slow glide around. Now, I know that there's a chance that my astronaut may actually leave the screen. So I'm going to also add a block, if on edge, to bounce. So I will hit the edge of the screen and come back in. I'm also going to give it the instruction to set the rotation to left, right. So it doesn't, astronaut doesn't turn upside down and do something a bit funny. I'm to test out our code to see if it works. So when the green flag clicks, oh no, I cannot see my astronaut. If I look down on this screen here, I can see in the information panel that my astronaut or my sprite is currently hidden. I don't want the astronaut on screen all the time, so let's add some blocks to tell him when to show and when to hide. So we need it to show at the very beginning when the green flag is clicked. So I'm going to add it into here to say, yeah, let's show on screen and continue to go. And then we're going to add, oh, here he is floating around right now. Fantastic. Oh, that makes me think of another dilemma. I don't want my astronaut flying around on the screen when the shoe is on there. So I'm going to have to create a broadcast that will tell all the sprites that are parts of the shoe when to be on screen and when to not be on screen. Let me click the stop button and let's work on this.
Title slide, controlling the sprites on screen, broadcast.
So underneath this sprite where he's done all of his speech, when he gets to the end, we're going to create a new broadcast. It's like sending a secret message. So let's click down and create a new message. I'm going to call it shoe.
Typing broadcast name.
Okay. Once he has received shoe, let's bring that across. When I receive we're going to make him hide. Okay, let's test this out just for our astronaut. There he comes. Oh, look. Gone to the back layer. Can you design a new shoe? Click on each part of the shoe. Oh, yep, he's hidden. Now, we need to go back to each
title slide, all sprites.
The other sprite part of the shoe and do the same. So on the shoe top, let's add into the shoe top. When the green flag is clicked, it's going to hide. And then when it receives the broadcast of shoe, it's going to show. Now I need to do that for the shoe bottom as well. Let's hide when the green flag is clicked. When I receive shoe, we're going to show. The logo as well, hide on the green flag, but let's show when the shoe is received. And the laces, the last one, let's hide. When I receive shoe, we are going to sew. Okay, I think I've got my project all set now. It's time to test. I'm going to go to the full screen to try the test. Let's click the green flag.
Project showing on screen.
Yes, my shoe parts are hidden. My astronaut's giving some instructions. Oh, I like the slowness. And my shoe is ready to go. Let's see what shoe I'm going to create this time. Oh, there's some great choices here. Oh, I like the yellow and blue. Oh, perfect. Here's my new shoe for the astronaut. What is your shoe going to look like?
Title slide, the final step.
In our game, we'd also like the coders to be able to change the background. So let's click on our backdrop stage area. And if we click on the backdrops tab now, you will see lots of different choices in there. You'll also notice that some of the blocks are a little bit different because they're applying to the backdrop instead of our sprites. So let's add in when the green flag is clicked and tell it exactly which backdrop to start with. And I want it to start with the backdrop galaxy. And in the events now, I'm going to click on when the stage is clicked. And I'm going to tell it to swap to the next backdrop. Now, when we click our background, we can also change what our shoe looks like.
Title slide, challenges.
Congratulations on completing your Moonhack project. Now, what are you going to do to really make this project uniquely yours? Perhaps you're going to go in and change some of the costumes and create your own. Perhaps you're going to take the idea and it's not going to be about a space shoe, it might be a space rocket that somebody gets to create. Perhaps you're going to add some information so people learn about the invention that we're showcasing here. We'd love to receive your project here at Moonhack, so get your trusted adult to send it through and share with us. And you might just be featured in our Scratch Studio or on the Moonhack website. We hope you have fun and you go and try another Moonhack project. Happy coding, everyone.
End of video title card. Thanks for coding with us.